Hey, welcome to a new video. In this week's video, I'm showing you my time in England. So, keep watching. Hey, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Fleur. I live in Belgium and I study forensics in the Netherlands. I'm in my fourth and final year of forensics, and for this year I have to do an internship followed by a graduation internship, and that's exactly where this video is about. I've done my internship the past 5 months in England, so I also lived the past 5 months in England, and I had this amazing time that I wanted to share with you guys. My internship was about Asian medication and what was inside of them, if they are made of illegal products or not. So this will be kind of my recap video about my past months in England at Euclid in Preston, so the north of England, if you don't know where that is. So get yourself a snack, a little drink, because this probably will be a longer video. First of all, the goal of my time in England was obviously my internship, and I'm very lucky with the internship I had. My project was about, what I already said, finding DNA in the medication that was found by the police. It's Asian medication. And by finding the DNA, I was going to identify what kind of plants were used in them. So it was really something challenging for me because it's not what I'm used to doing, working with plant DNA. But it was really fun doing it. The biggest thing I learned was probably how to work on my own projects, actually how to work on myself, because at school they always tell us that we're gonna let you loose, you're gonna do it on your own, but they kind of still lead you how you have to do it. And now for the first time I actually had to do something out of myself, find my own solutions to problems and everything. And there was a teacher that would help you if you were stuck, but most of the part you got to do it yourself, and I really loved that. I really liked that I could find my own solutions to problems, and I found out that I actually can do it. So I really liked it, and I'm really thankful for the project that I could do there. I really learned a lot, and that's the reason why I wanted to go there. But the university didn't only have the internship. It's a very big university with so many opportunities. By example, they had so many clubs and groups where you could join, like the dance club that I joined every Thursday, and I think also some Wednesdays I went dancing. I did hip hop, I did jazz, and I tried even tap just for fun. So I really made some friends there. I really loved it. What I also did was the radio station of Euclid at Pulse Radio. And I learned how to work with a radio, and you could enjoy my cram hour every Thursday for 1.5 hours. So I really enjoyed doing that. It was an experience I didn't know that was possible, but I'm very happy that I could do it. But apart from those clubs, Euclid also had a big forensics program going on there, and I met Claire, who is a teacher there, and absolutely one of the nicest and fun people that I met there. And she gave me the opportunity to follow some classes like advanced CSI, some really cool labs, but also my favorite, forensic photography. And I can just not express how thankful I am to her and to all the teachers that let me come to their classes, to have that opportunity to follow those classes, to learn so much other things than that I have learned at my school, and to see a bigger part of forensics. But I was out of school, and that's also the last great thing I did in England, was travel in the weekends. And I got a list here next to me of all the places I visited, because obviously I just can't remember them out of my head anymore. But I visited Manchester, Liverpool, Blackpool, Hathersage, the Lake District, Chipping, Lancaster, London, York, Hope, Edinburgh, Leeds, Bolton, and I went to the Lion King musical and to my first ballet. So So if you do all that, you kind of get a half year like this. Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. Can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. Pretty sure I took everything that I could out of my time in England, and I honestly enjoyed every minute of it. I will miss it dearly, but I'm also happy to be back. I always loved the idea of England and always dreamed about going and living in England for like a really long part of my life. So people actually before I went told me that it would be disappointing because I had such a big hopes of England. But it never disappointed me. It has been exactly what I hoped for and maybe even more. And yeah, I'm very happy that I could do this half year, that I was able to do all the things that I did, learn all the things that I learned, meet all the people that I met. And it may be a little bit cringy that I'm doing this kind of video or like saying all these things, but I really mean it, and I feel like I really learned myself a little bit better, really enjoyed my last half year like I should have. So I'm very happy how I did it. I wouldn't change it in the world. I will miss hearing English every day. Now hearing Dutch outside is still a little bit weird, and I'm here already 2 weeks back in Belgium. But it's still weird to hear people talk Dutch. I will also miss how I could walk to my favorite bookshop, Hillwood & Sons. It was a second-hand bookshop, and it was just so magical to go there. And yeah, I will miss that. I will also miss traveling to new places by train. That was only like 12 minutes walk away from my home. So I just walked there, and the train took me wherever I wanted to go. I miss the radio and saying, "You're listening to Creme Hour on Pulse Radio." Yeah, I will miss that. I also miss screwing up the dance at the dance club and just laughing about it. What I won't be missing is all the spicy food and maybe the tap water. But most of all, I will miss all the people, all the friends I made over there, the people I met that really meant something to me, like Yasmin, Justine, Mirte, Josette, my amazing roommates Louise and Rebecca, Claire, all the Poles that gave me classes, and Rebecca where I worked with, and of course Judith that gave me my internship. So yeah, I'm really thank you that I could meet you and have this amazing time with you all, if you're watching. But now I'm ready for my next adventure in Antwerp. More about that next week. I will explain what I'm doing now. Yeah, you already know from the beginning of this video that I will be doing a graduation internship, and I'm doing that in Antwerp, but I will tell you more about that. So if you aren't subscribed, you should do that, otherwise you maybe will miss my next video. And I hope to see you next week when you subscribed. I hope you all liked this video. I sure did. And I hope you have a great week. Bye!